Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the iconographer of this video. For today, you will see me painting the holy icon of Saint George, and I will focus more on the process of painting his clothes, and especially the parts of his clothes that will receive the so-called Chrisokondilia, a cold, supposedly cold linery. Let's say, and I will try to explain my process of painting these straight lines that for many beginner iconographers are an issue they struggle with. So I do hope that all of you are fine, creative, that you spend time in your studio, and you are well and healthy during these strange times that we experience. As many of you who follow this channel know, what I'm doing now is I'm having transferred my drawing on my board, and now I'm doing some very basic underpainting. I'm drawing with a brush the facial characteristics of the face of Saint George. Now, this is not a common icon of Saint George that I'm using as a reference. Saint George is standing here and piercing the dragon while he stands. Normally, Saint George is depicted on a horse or standing and blessing as a martyr. We rarely see icons where he stands and he's killing the dragon while in this position. So anyway, now you see me painting the base colors, the proplasmi of the clothes of Saint George. The clothes that will receive the Chrisokondilies, the gold lines, where for this video I will not make them for gold. I have made another tutorial where I use actual gold to create this technique, this Chrisokondilia lines. For this video, many subscribers have requested me to use actual color, so it will be easy for them to understand how to make these straight golden, let's say, lines. So the area of his clothes that will receive the gold line here is this brown ochre color on his torso and his arm and shoulder. So I just prepare a proplasmo that normally I mix yellow ochre, some black, and maybe some green, or also a little bit of cadmium yellow. I don't have any recipes. I just try to see how I will make this color. So now you see me painting the grapsimata, the shadow parts, on exactly these elements that will receive the golden lines, or the yellow lines in this case. I do hope that this makes sense and you understand what I'm talking about. I know that the video is more important and stronger, and sometimes you don't even need to understand what I'm talking about. The video itself is self-explanatory. Many people ask me to make videos in other languages, in Greek, of course, since I'm Greek. I'm pretty sure you can understand many things just by watching these videos. At some point, I will do a video in Greek, and yeah. So as you see here, I'm using the tip of my line and the usual way of painting the γραψίματα, which is a linear way, and I try to blend and soften these γραψίματα, these shadow lines, to the base color, to the προπλασμό, with using the tip of my brush and using a very transparent darker color. In this case, I make this color using for the προπλασμό of the clothes that will be that will receive the yellow lines. I make the shadow parts by using some of the προπλασμό, some as I said, yellow ochre, red, some black, some green, and then I will darken it by adding a little bit of iron oxide red and just a tiny little bit of black. Here at this point of the video, you see, you watch me doing something different. I paint the red robe cloth of Saint George. This is one, in my opinion, of the hardest clothes in iconography. This bright red that is used in many icons. It's very hard to be achieved the way the old icons are painted, and I probably should make a separate, more thorough video on how to paint and achieve this orange red color, which is completely bright and hard to achieve in reality. So as you see, for I will try to explain my process here a little bit. I've used for the προπλασμό of this red cloth, I've used some cadmium yellow, some red, which can be cadmium red, or if you have some other carmine red. And if I'm not mistaken, this is a carmine red that I've used for the προπλασμό, some cadmium yellow, and pretty much this is the προπλασμό. It has to be very very rich and very bright, and then I will use just for the γραψίματα, for the shadow, for the folds of this cloth, I've used a little bit of the προπλασμό and more pure carmine red, or I will also add a little bit of cadmium red, just a tiny little bit. Then I will use for the φωτίσματα, as you see here, I will use some part of my base color, and I will add a little bit of cadmium yellow, and for the second light that you see me here painting, I will use even more of this cadmium yellow. If it looks too yellowy, I can mix it with some carmine red, and there will be my φωτίσματα. This red color that we often see in houses of in architecture as decoration of houses in iconography, and in the clothes of many martyrs, sometimes the cloth of Saint Anna, mother of Virgin Mary, wears such a red cloth, is hard to achieve and understand its beauty if you haven't seen old icons live, close by, in reality. Reproductions are very hard to reproduce the beauty of this red. This video also the same. I don't think in reality things look a little bit better, but you get an idea how to paint this red color. We do not light this φωτίσματα on the red with using white. We just use some yellow or some yellowy other color. Now I will slow down the video here, and I will show you how I will paint these yellow lines here. This is what the video is about today, and so for this I never use a liner brush, and for this first two yellow lines I decided to experiment a little and see if by using this long brush liner, as it is called, brush, a long hair brush, if this will be easier for me. I'm pretty sure that the best way to do these lines is by using a liner. The thing is that I'm not at all accustomed, and you see here how I struggle to paint this yellow line using a long hair brush. It doesn't look satisfying to me, it doesn't look good, so as you see here I've changed to my normal brush, which is a short hair brush. And with this I will try, of course, by observing my reference, to imitate exactly all the lines that I see that the master iconographer has painted on his icon. Now, I created this color by mixing cadmium yellow with white, and that's it, pretty much that's it. The consistency of the color is important, and it should be a color that is opaque enough to have some strength, and to cover enough just by one stroke. Now, this also, I understand that you have to feel in control of your brush. The whole idea here is to know how your brush behaves. And of course, as I said, it would be better to use or to get accustomed, if you haven't been accustomed to any brush yet for these lines, it's better to try and master the use of a long hair brush, in my opinion. It's something that it's on my checklist as an iconographer, to master a long hair brush for these lines. But for now I will use the short hair brush that I am so comfortable and in control, feel in control when I'm doing these lines. Now, you have to understand that there is some pattern when we paint these lines, and these lines are almost often comb-like lines. They are almost parallel, but at the same time not exactly parallel. They should begin, they should start, and let's say, well, I can't find a word. They should, let's say, explode out of their central form in a way that is that makes sense, that is thicker on their base, and as they expand, no, it's not that the word, but as they, as we paint them, we should make them thinner, and more, let's say, delicate. Just follow the form that you see on the reference, and try to be as close to that as possible. As you see here, I take my time, I try to understand how to paint these lines, and I go on. I'm sorry if this is all confusing to you, or if I confuse you more than explaining the process to you. These Chrisokondilies are very beautiful when they are achieved with gold leaves, and if you haven't yet seen the video where I explained the process. You can find it on my video list. This is interesting though here, painting them with color. Many iconographers do not have an easy access to gold leaf, or you know, gold leaf is an expensive material, and for beginner iconographers it's better to exercise and practice their skills just by using this yellow and white color. It's fine in my opinion if it's done in a nice way. Try not to be shaky, try to have a stable hand, and the lines to end in a very thin and fine, let's say, style. As you see, I don't make the line in one stroke, in one attempt. I just progressively create these lines. This is my style. Some other iconographers, I'm sure, they paint the line in one stroke. The important is to by the end of this way, this style, this painting, to have lines that are almost parallel. They are not shaky, and they are nice to see, to watch. So I want to thank you all for watching this video. I hope this was helpful to you, and that you learned something out of this video. I try my best to explain the process as best I can, and I do hope that this will inspire you to make your own studies and practice more in iconography. Thank you for commenting. Your comments are amazing. Please, if you find this video helpful, like the video, and if you haven't yet, please consider subscribing, as more tutorials are about to come. Thank you so much again. Feel free, if you like, to support this channel on patreon.com. You'll find the description below. It's really amazing that people support this channel in many ways. I do hope that you like the outcome of this icon so far, with these yellow lines, and feel free to send me your progress on my email that is listed below. Thank you all so much. Have a blessed week, and a very creative one. Bye. I will see you soon.